So, The Foggy Dew, one of the greatest Irish rebel songs of all time. I think nearly every Irish person knows this song, but actually, funnily enough, it's not known all around the world. And Conor McGregor pretty much made this song world famous, which is great. So, what's the history of The Foggy Dew? The Foggy Dew was written in the year 1919 by a young priest in County Antrim by the name of Charles O'Neill. The song was essentially written in the aftermath of the 1916 Easter Rising. The 1916 Easter Rising, in short, was a rebellion against the British Empire in Ireland to gain independence for Ireland. So in 1919, the young Charles O'Neill, who was 32 years old at the time, attended the very first meeting in the Dáil Éireann on the 21st of January in the Mansion House in Dublin. Coincidentally, the 21st of January 1919 was actually the very first day of the Irish War of Independence. So in 1916, as the Easter Rising was happening, you also had World War I at the very same time, and a lot of Irishmen went to fight for Britain at that time, roughly about 200 to 210,000 Irishmen. Charles and a lot of other Irish people at the time had mixed feelings about this, because they were going fighting for the British Empire in World War I when they could have stayed at home and fought for a republic. And essentially, the Foggy Dew states that the men that went and fought for Britain during World War I would die in lonely graves, and the men that stayed in Ireland and stayed by Padraig Pearse's side and fought for a republic would be honoured and remembered. Now, did he actually mean these words? I think he had a lot of mixed emotions going on at the time of the writing of this song. A lot of people in Ireland at the time had mixed emotions. It was a really, really difficult time in Irish history. And a lot of the Irish men that went to fight for Britain in World War I ended up coming back to Ireland and actually training the Irish Republican Army on how to use guns. And they ended up being heroes in the end, because the Irish Republican Army had no experience on how to use guns, no training, so these lads showed them what it was like to fight in an actual battle. And without those men that went to fight in World War I with Britain, the Irish Republican Army would not have been the same. An interesting lyric from this song is, "'Twas better to die 'neath that Irish sky than at Sulva or Sud Elbar." This is the perfect example of what Charles and a lot of other Irish people were feeling at the time. As men were going to fight for Britain in World War I, they felt betrayed in a way. They felt betrayed that these men weren't staying in Ireland to fight for the Republic alongside Padraig Pearse and all of the Irish Republican Army leaders. Another interesting point about this song is that it actually wasn't originally a song, it was a poem. Charles released this poem in 1919, and he actually didn't even put his name to the work. These were very unsure and dangerous times in Ireland at the time. Charles just didn't want his name on the work, he didn't want to bring any unwanted attention towards him, I guess. Charles O'Neill died on the 8th of May 1963 and left behind him one of the greatest Irish songs of all time. This song has been covered hundreds of times by numerous artists over the last century, and funnily enough, my favourite version is actually the version that Conor McGregor walks out to. It's Sinead O'Connor and the Chieftains. And this is a brief story behind Conor McGregor's walkout song, The Foggy Dew by Charles O'Neill. Thanks for watching, don't forget to subscribe for future videos. In my dream.